Now from downtown Cleveland and Progressive Field, MLB The Show has action out of the AL Central. It's the Chicago White Sox taking on the Cleveland Guardians. John Shambi alongside Chris Singleton, singing a pair of top-level arms on the mound today.
I think what makes these guys so great is their tempo. They don't take very much time in between pitches. It doesn't give the hitters an opportunity to try to think with you and gain an advantage in this chess match.
First pitch coming your way next. So almost ready to get underway and towing the slab for the Cleveland Guardians. Early win.
Well, he got into the eighth inning his last time out, really pitching deep in the games as of late. We'll see today how many innings he's got in him.
All right, ready to get underway. Now the batter now, Shoeless Joe Jackson.
Leading off for the White Sox, Shoeless Joe Jackson.
The why to kick the pitch. And he bunts, but that's a foul ball.
First pitch, 6-10.
Righty to the plate. That clips the corner.
Out there on the mound, he's setting the tone early with the fastball, 98 miles per hour up on the scoreboard.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And one gone.
Man, how many times do you see three fastballs in an at-bat like that? I'm sure once he got to two strikes, he was trying to stay back for something off speed and just not ready for that third fastball.
And now, Mini Minoso. Good contact guy, good defender. Swings through that one, 0-1. No score, just getting started, top of the first. The pitch. Swings and misses, back-to-back strikeouts.
Well, anytime you can punch out the top two guys in a lineup to start an inning, got to be feeling pretty good out there on the mound, because when you think of just having a distraction, table setters on the base paths, and all of a sudden you're dealing with the number three hitter, any distraction can cause you to serve up a cookie, and instead of it being a solo shot, it's a two or three run homer.
Lofton makes the catch, and that'll do it. Middle of the first. Now the Guardians will get their shot, still scoreless. Bottom of the first. On the hill for the White Sox, Wood.
There's always a bit of a learning curve for rookie pitchers. You've got to get familiar with these big league hitters, and it's more of a chess match, but I think this kid's got good stuff and the potential to be great.
Brett Thomas getting loose there. He's now in the game at first.
Now playing first.
We go to the bottom of the first, and now the center fielder, Kenny Lofton.
Leading off.
And a pitch.
Guardians, the center fielder.
And he lays down a bunt. Thomas. He is safe, and that was bang, bang at first.
It doesn't surprise anyone when he gets on base by dropping down a bunt. I mean, this is just the latest example of him using his speed to his advantage and showing off his skills with the bat. That was very nice.
Stepping up for the Guardians, number 16. Move over to first, trying to keep him close. Bunting for a hit. Durham to first, one gone, bottom half of the first. Here's the Guardians lineup now. A very athletic offensive group with speed spread throughout this offense.
Yeah, and it's so important that they have patient and quality at-bats because the key is to get on base. If they do that, then they can create a whole lot of havoc on the base pass, get guys around to score, and then that's going to get you some good pitches to hit as well. So a very athletic team, and we should be in for a treat in this one.
It's not the standard approach that we see in today's game, but it does work for them offensively. Number eight watches that one for a strike, standing in here with one down. One out and a runner at second. To the left side, but it is well foul. And that one ripped into right, drops into the glove, and there's two down.
Batting four, the right fielder,
Manny Ramirez, digs in for the Guardians. This is another guy capable of hitting tape measure home runs. This one in the dirt. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Second inning coming up from Progressive Field. No score. Back now at Progressive Field. Second inning set to go. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Sox, Harold Baines. Now the right-hander ready to go. Still no score. And fouled off.
Very dominant with that fastball inside. Hitter's going to be conscious of that. Now you have the outer half of the plate to work with out there on the mound.
0-2 as he waves at that one.
Larry Bullard making the calls behind the plate for us in this one. Pretty good strike zone. Well reviewed by those we talked to around the league.
Yeah, he's an umpire. He doesn't get a lot of looks from players. Maybe here and there once in a while, but he's appreciated back there. Next pitch is inside, and it's 1-2. What about some no-nos? Like, you can't call the umpire blue the way you do in Little League or high school, right?
Yeah, even in the minor leagues, you'll learn quickly. You call the umpire blue. You better learn his name, and that's just part of being a pro.
Next pitch is popped up. Grabs it barehanded, and very nicely done for the out. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
Frank Thomas takes a ball here as he stands in now. One down, base is empty. That's down and in. No score here in the second. Swings and misses. 2-1 now. Right-hander kicks, deals. Wouldn't chase that time. Three-one now. Fought off foul.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
And he walked him.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make a call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
Ray Durham, the next to hit. Here's a guy who's been struggling so far this year. It's only late April, but still hoping he'll turn it around soon. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Always tough to turn two on a speedster like this. It's even harder with him coming out of the left-handed batter's box. You really need something to hit hard on the ground that they can handle to turn two quickly.
The next pitch misses, and that's ball two.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
This one high in the air to left center. He's got it. And there are two down.
Batting seven, the third baseman.
Digging in, number 23. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list. That one's in there, 0-1.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner, got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect him to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
At the belt and fires. Got him swinging. And that is that. The White Sox leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here in Cleveland, bottom half of inning number two. Now the four-hole hitter for the Guardians, Manny Ramirez.
The right fielder, Manny Ramirez.
The wind of the pitch. So what are the skills you look for that make a really good defensive third baseman that elite?
Well, Boog, one of the things I think about immediately are just the feet. Does he have good feet? Is he able to quickly react? And when you have good feet, you've got soft hands. And soft hand defenders are able to make tough plays look easy.
That one to first, and it goes just foul. Stays alive. Right through there, got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
No, that's not the best two-strike fastball I've seen, but certainly got away with the location there. You know, sometimes as a hitter, when you're down in the count, you're so focused on a pitcher painting the black, and you just get a little bit locked up on something down the heart of the plate, not expecting it, and it just kind of freezes you.
And now number nine. First offering misses the mark. Nothing here in the bottom of the second. Left-hand batter waits. And 1-2.
Count 1-2.
And the pitch. And it's even up. Kicks and fires. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Now two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Larry Doby.
Next is the designated hitter, Larry Doby. He's got four hits in the series on nine at-bats. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And now the lefty. A bit behind with that swing. It's strike one.
Wow. Good luck catching up to that one.
Left-hand hitter waits. Popped up. Aparicio settles underneath it and makes the grab. And that is that. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. We'll move to the third with no score. Welcome back. Here's the veteran shortstop, Luis Aparicio.
Leading off,
you talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. In there for a strike at the top of the zone.
Yeah, we go beyond just the fielding percentage and what it looks like, but the ability to have a range and close holes that are normally there against an average defender. But this guy is special, and you can see it in his first step quickness.
Next pitch misses inside, and the count is 1-2. Righty delivers. Popped up right side. Number 16 under it. One up, one down.
Batting nine, the catcher, number 10.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Number 10.
Boog, and the one thing about that is speed never goes in a slump, and defense shouldn't either. Hitting wise, you can struggle, you can lose your mechanics, but the thing that you can do consistently every single game is play great defense if you're talented in that way, and this is what this guy does.
The 1-0. Out in front with the swing, and that is strike one. Swing and a miss. It's a ball and two strikes. Top of the third, no score. Breaks his bat and pops it up. Win makes the grab, two down.
Now batting, the center fielder, Shoeless Joe Jackson.
Back to the top of the White Sox lineup. Here's the center fielder, Shoeless Joe Jackson. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. The pitch. And he drops it down the third baseline. Scoops it up barehanded. On the money, nice play. We head now to the home half of inning number three. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Set for the bottom of the third, and now the switch hitting catcher, Victor Martinez. Maybe not an elite level switch hitter, but still a guy. Some contact and just success as a hitter for both sides of the plate. Wood back to work.
Well, he doesn't get too big with the swing. He knows how to hit behind runners, and those are guys that can just smell that RBI. So when you're talking about a consistent player like this that can give you good at-bats from each side of the plate, that's the guy that you're going to see many times coming up big.
The lefty ready, and a 1-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Just a weak fly ball this time. Durham makes the catch. One down.
Batting eight, the third baseman, number 2.
And up next for Cleveland, number two. Singing, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
Next offering is in for a strike. The wind and the pitch. Rolled slowly to first. Thomas takes it to the bag, and two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third.
Batting none. The shortstop, number five.
Number five digs in for the Guardians. The MO for him is contact, the guy who's going to deliver average, not a ton of power. He's looking to hit a line drive somewhere.
Y'all, that's why it's a team. And when you look at a lineup, he's a great two-hole hitter or a guy that you could put at the bottom to help turn that lineup over to have some momentum for your top hitters coming up to the plate.
Next pitch misses inside. Two balls, no strikes. Two down, nobody on. He swings and fouls one off. Next one misses, ball three. The pitch. And that's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Lofton in the box for the second time. One ball, no strikes. Next offering is fouled back. Ball and a strike. That one catches the corner for a strike.
One ball, two strikes. Yeah.
And a ball evens the count. Two, two now. Line drive to short and caught. One left for the Guardians, and we are still scoreless. And welcome back. Start of the fourth, and stepping in is the speedy Mini Minoso.
The left fielder, number nine.
The right-hander back to work.
Minoso.
And ball one.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Next pitch misses, ball two.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
On the ground, right side. Throws to first, leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
So now it's the White Sox DH, Paul Konerko. In there for strike one.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
And a pitch. Strike two. And a pitch. And down on strikes. Two away.
No, you know that's got to be very frustrating for this guy. He knows the strike zone extremely well. And you know what? Good hitters are not going to compromise. He'll take that punch out, but ultimately stick with his plan and have more success than anything else.
Now, Harold Baines. First pitch doesn't find the zone. The White Sox hitless so far in the game. Next offering misses, 2-0.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
The next offering misses, and that's ball three. Two outs. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
That just came apart right there. Four-pitch walk, and guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
Two outs, runner at first. And up next for Chicago, Frank Thomas. He reached on a walk his first time. Checks over to first, back safely. And that's a base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ball game.
Durham in the box lays off for ball one. And here it comes. Late with the swing there.
I guess you throw it that hard, you can get away with locations like that right down the middle. But I still think it's a dangerous pitch. Don't want to do it again.
Next offering is in for a strike. First and second, two down. Next offering is fouled back. The pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Kicks and deals. Fastball, and he gets out of the way.
You see how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Here's the 2-2. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Heading for the plate. Now a long throw home. Safe at the plate. And it's 1-0. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
Number 23 steps to the plate for the White Sox. And that's in there for strike one. And downstairs. The 1-1. Hit hard but foul off to the left. And a swing and a miss. Good job at damage control right there. To the bottom of inning number four now. It's the White Sox 1 and the Guardians nothing. Bottom four. Now it's the second baseman, number 16.
For the Guardians, the second baseman,
the pitch.
Number 16.
Good eye right there.
Counts 1-0.
Here comes a pitch. Going to count 1-2.
I got to count 1-2.
Just misses with that one.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. In time to get him, one away in the strikeout.
The batter, number 8.
Number 8, getting ready to hit. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. And that one fouled off.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Jackson right there to make the grab. Two down.
Now batting, right fielder, Manny Ramirez.
Two outs, bases empty. Now at the plate, Manny Ramirez. Caught looking his first time up. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
The 0-1.
And what makes him even quicker is the fact that he's so dialed in on the pitch as it's moving through the hitting zone. He can see how that hitter's lined up, what he's trying to do, and where that pitch is going to end up, which gives him that really quick first step. And that's why he makes so many great plays.
Next one misses, and that's ball three. The why to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. The why to the pitch. Foul ball. Kicks and fires. swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Three balls, two strikes, the count. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Got him looking. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. The Guardians go down in order. Still behind by a count of 1-0. When I'm waking, I feel so dangerous. Here in Cleveland, top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Luis Aparicio. And a pitch. That's to third. Zips it across, and the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. You got to be kidding me. Did you see that throw?
Not really, Boog. I mean, it happened in the blink of an eye, it seemed, but thankfully StatCast is here to help us out. I mean, you don't see many throws across the infield that get up into the 90s, so he really reached back for that one, and he had to get the out.
So up next for Chicago, number 10. First offering misses the mark.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
And the right-hander deals. Swings and misses. And the count even at one. And he deals. And that chance handled. And the first two set down in the top of the fifth.
Up next for the White Sox, the center fielder, Shoeless Joe Jackson.
Back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Shoeless Joe Jackson. And a bunt towards third. And he picks it up in foul territory. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
This guy's not wasting any pitches. Hitters got to get into swing mode. This is a good time to expand the zone. Throw something maybe down in the dirt.
That one misses, and that's ball one. And that's down and away.
Two balls, two strikes.
The wind of the pitch. Down the left field line. Could be extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. And he's in with a stand-up double.
Well, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
Man at second here with two away. Next to hit, Mini Minoso. The other way. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. So a man left for the White Sox, but they're on top 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. And now, number 9.
He's hitting for that pop. Came out of the gates really strong.
The wind and the pitch. Ball one, no strikes. The pitch. Inside corner, that's a strike. And a count 1-1. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Bounced up the middle. Lays out. He's got it. Nicely done for the out.
Well, this is obviously a tremendous play, but for me, it starts with a well-broken-in glove. To have the confidence to go down, knowing that ball is going to be right in the pocket, so you've got a clean transfer, pop back up to the feet, and fire across the diamond. Outstanding job.
Larry Doby digs in for the Guardians. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Left-hand batter waits. Slap the other way, foul. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. And a pitch. This one ripped, but foul to the right. The pitch. Stays alive. The 1-2. Just misses the mark outside the zone.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. That one the other way. Fair ball. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Now only two it. Hits allowed so far tonight, Boog, so I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
And next is the Guardians catcher, Victor Martinez. And this is a guy that doesn't just impact the game defensively. They count on him to deliver offense.
He's the first guy at the ballpark. He's got to study the opposing hitters. He's got to get familiar with his starting pitcher for that night. And he's getting in the cage to take his swings. That's a whole lot and so many times goes unnoticed.
And now the lefty, runner on the goal. The throw, tag, and he's out.
You know, sometimes a throw that bounces into second base can be just as good as a perfect throw in the air. Almost a little bit easier to handle at second base. For me, that caught stealing right there was all about a really poor jump off first. Just didn't time it well, and he was toast after that.
And here it comes. In there. And so now 1-2. The pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes.
Number two.
Number two, now at the plate. Ground ball to the right side. Into the outfield, base hit. So that's two straight, two out hits.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Just one of those seen eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock. Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
First and second, two outs. Number five digs in now, and that one fouled off.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. into center. Jackson makes the catch, and that'll do it. Guardians strand a couple. They're down 1-0. Back here in Cleveland, top six. Here's the White Sox DH, Paul Konerko.
The designated hitter, Paul Konerko.
The right-hander back to work. That one missed.
Counts 1-0.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That catches the corner. The pitch. And a count 1-2.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Next offering is foul back. Down to the dirt, swing and a miss. In time. And a drop third strike leads to the first out.
Now batting the right fielder, Harold Baines.
Now it's the right fielder, Harold Baines. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Right side, hard hit. The throw to first, and that's an out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Frank Thomas.
Two outs, base is empty. And next to hit for the Sox, Frank Thomas. This guy makes great contact, one of the best in the game at putting bat on ball.
He's got such quick hands, and he's gaining pitch recognition. That keeps him square to the plate, and there's a good chance that his bat stays in the zone a long time, and that produces solid contact consistently.
Over to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the White Sox 1, and the Guardians nothing. Bottom of the sixth. Here's the Cleveland leadoff hitter, Kenny Lofton.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
And that's through there for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
I think he was a little excited there, saw the fastball, but needed a stepladder to get to that one. He's going to have to tighten it back up if he wants to have a good at-bat.
0-2 now.
Ball one. Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
And a 1-2 again. And now 2-2.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where a pitcher would rather just give up a first pitch single than have to waste six or seven pitches on one hitter.
Next offering misses. Counts full, 3-2. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Three, two now. And so the lefty allows the leadoff free pass.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
So in now for Cleveland, number 16.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
First offering misses the mark.
Good speed on the base paths. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Nobody out. Runner at first. Pitch misses inside. And now 2-0. Chris, with that distraction and a speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
And a pitch. Late swing, fouled off. At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Next one just misses. And a full count now. Runner at first with no outs here. And a swing and a miss. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. Stepping up for the Guardians, number 8.
Oh, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation. Well, no base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard, because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me.
Lofton on the goal. They pitch out. Throw to second. He's safe. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
And a pitch. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Baines pulls it down. Runner tags, and we'll move up to third. And he moves up to third, now two away.
The right fielder.
So digging in, Manny Ramirez, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Into center field, that'll fall for a hit. The tying run is in to score from third. It's 1-1.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine, another clutch run scoring it back.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. Runner at first with two away. Next is the speedy first baseman, number 9. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. To the right side, has some trouble with it, and that is the inning. But they pick up one run on the RBI single, all even now at 1-1. I remember as a child, music made me smile. Some people called it rhythm and soul. I could never get enough of this kind of stuff, because I think the... Welcome back. Here's a speed threat, Ray Durham.
Leading off for the White Sox, the second baseman.
Yeah, the right hander back to work. That one way outside. Ball one. Way high. The wind to kick the 2-0. And it's fouled away. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. And out 2-2.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Picks up strikeout number 7. Number 23 steps to the plate for the White Sox. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. First pitch, and he just misses. Smoked into left, base hit.
You know, I was watching his rounds during batting practice today. So impressed with his ability to let the ball travel, go back up the middle and the other way. Sometimes when you step in the box during the game, you get a little anxious and you get away from that. But so far, I've seen him stay consistent with his pregame preparation.
And the batter now, Luis Aparicio. Next offering is down low. Ball one. One away, tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. Next pitch inside. 2 balls and a strike.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Righty delivers. First offering. Runner goes. Foul ball there. Got him. That's out number 2.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a 2-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. With all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate. So very difficult to get the barrel on it.
Number 10 stands in now and watches strike one. 2 gone, the possible go-ahead run at first. Ground ball left side. They take the force out. That's the 3rd out. 7th inning stretch time. All tied 1-1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now it's the Guardians DH.
For the Guardians, the designated hitter, Larry Doby.
And the pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Bullpen activity starting up now. Number 15, the left-hander, up and throwing. Number 56, getting loose as well. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away.
Going to have a little more discipline in future at-bats. That pitch looked good, but you can't hit it. It was just too high in the zone. You usually see a swing and miss or weak contact in the infield.
Martinez in the box now. No balls and a strike. The 0-1. And a foul ball. That one ripped. Base hit right field. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Well, that was an important at-bat in this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. Now a huge at-bat in this game coming up.
Number two digs in for the Guardians. First pitch just misses. And he deals.
He's going.
Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Swing and a ball popped up. That gets down for a hit. To third, not in time. And it's runners at the corners with one gone.
Now, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a long dart in there, and he found a way.
Now a good opportunity to potentially jump ahead in this game here in the later innings.
Manager out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Wood done for the night. White Sox going with a new arm, Doc White. This is his fifth appearance of the year. One down. Number five, the next to hit. And first offering is fouled off. Runners are at the corners, one away. Ball one there.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Next pitch is inside, and it's 2-1.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on, two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Next offering clips the zone count even at two.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
The next offering misses. Full count 3-2. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
Lofton at the plate now, and that's inside.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Kicks and deals. That pitch clips the outside corner, and it's a ball and a strike. Swings through that one.
Gonna really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
One out, base is full. Got him! Huge strikeout there.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step up and get the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty big two-out at bat coming up now.
Number 16 digs in for the Guardians. This one squared up down the left field line. If it's fair, it's gone. It's fair, and it is gone. He'll touch them all. His first homer of the year. It's 5-1. Chris, we knew this moment was coming for him soon.
Yep, and it finally came. We knew it was only a matter of time before he's going to connect with one just like that. Just too good of a hitter at the plate.
Now the left fielder, number 8.
Now batting, number 8.
Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, they've kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
The wind to kick the pitch. And a swing and a miss.
Quickly in an 0-2 count, you've got to figure out a way to shorten your path to the baseball. Put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
The wind of the pitch. Next offering misses down and away. Two down, nobody on. Stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Misses. And the count is 2-2.
I got the count 2-2.
And now it's filled up. Got him. Inning over, although plenty of damage done. But the damage was done right here as you get another look at the Grand Slam home run. It's now a 5-1 ball game. Ready to begin the 8th. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Shoeless Joe Jackson.
Shoeless Joe.
Win back to work. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Nice grab on the run. And there's one down.
Now batting, left fielder, Mini.
Now the number 2 hitter, Mini Minoso. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. In there, and it's 0-1.
And I would say that most great defensive outfielders, it's kind of natural. There is some work that you can do to it to improve your game, but ultimately, you either have it or you don't.
And now the 0-1. Grips one to right and puts the squeeze on that one. Two up, two down.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
There's one guy that I can think about, Boog, who started as a third baseman, Alex Gordon, and then became an elite perennial gold glover out in left field for the Kansas City Royals. But he's a guy, when you watch him play, you would imagine that that's all he ever played in his life was the outfield.
Canerco in the box with two gone. And takes a look at a called strike. And there's a foul ball. Yeah, some guys just have instincts, right? I mean, that's the way it goes. We talk about Larry Walker, the Hall of Famer, and his instinct on the bases, despite the fact that he didn't play a ton of baseball as a kid. And the next pitch is way outside. swing and a miss, struck him out. That ends the frame. Nothing doing for the White Sox. They're down 5-1. Back now at Progressive Field. On to the bottom of the eighth. And now the right fielder, Manny Ramirez.
The right fielder.
The pitch.
Manny Ramirez.
There's a strike. Remember Mark Kotze, he was a real good defensive outfielder. Good instincts, not great speed. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. A right-hander is up and throwing. Now the 0-1. And a foul ball left side.
Yeah, and I figured you would get Kotze into this because you had a free dinner at his house the other night.
That is true. 0-2 now. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. That one fouled off. The next pitch misses. 1-2 the count. And now the lefty. And down on strikes he goes. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Number 9, getting ready to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Kicks and fires.
Boom. 1-1.
And that one missing low.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Rip to third. Tosses to first. Two up, two down.
Up next for Cleveland, the designated hitter, Larry Doby.
And next is the designated hitter, Larry Doby. That one's in there, 0-1. The pitch. Now 1-1.
One ball, one strike.
And here it comes. In the air, left field, down the line. Minoso racing over to make the catch. Guardians go down 1-2-3. They lead this one, though, 5-1. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Doug Jones. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. And here is Harold Baines. The pitch. Bottom of the zone and a called strike. Movement in the pen for the Guardians. Kovaleski preparing to come on if needed. The wind and the pitch. And that one wrapped foul. Left-hand batter waits. Off the plate inside. And the count 1-2. The pitch stays alive. Right-hander kicks, deals, and now it's even up.
Two balls, two strikes.
Righty to the plate. Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. A towering home run, and they cut into the deficit. It's 5-2. That one just sounded different.
And might have been the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I can feel that swing from the booth. Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news. And all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame. Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
And a pitch. He swings and drives one out to deep left field. That one's carrying, and it hits the fence. Now a relay to second. In there. Just beat the tag. It's a double.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
And up next for Chicago, Ray Durham. And the first pitch misses for ball one. No outs, runner on second. Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Runner at second, nobody out. And the righty deals. On the ground to short. Sends it across to first. Now one gone in the ninth. You got to be kidding me. Did you see that throw?
Not really, Boog. I mean, it happened in the blink of an eye, it seemed, but thankfully StatCast is here to help us out. I mean, you don't see many throws across the infield that get up into the 90s, so he really reached back for that one, and he had to get the out.
Jose Mesa on a pitch out of the pen here, and he has some nasty breaking stuff.
Oh, he's having an excellent season so far. ERA is under 2. A lot of flexibility coming out of the bullpen.
Number 23 now at the plate. And first offering is fouled off. Runner at second here, one gone. On the ground, right side. And that one handled. Only play is at first on the throw from shallow right. Fine play in the hole for the out. Luis Aparicio steps to the plate for the White Sox. for the fourth time tonight. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. First pitch, not close.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
At the belt and fires. So now 1-2. Next pitch misses. The count now 2-2. And that's outside.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run and the on deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
Here comes a pitch. And there's ball four.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
White Sox down to their final out. Number 10 steps to the plate for the White Sox. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Just amazing to me how many closers and back-end relievers just throw absolute gas these days. I never would have had a chance.
Mesa, he's kind of a prototypical bullpen arm in today's game. Electric stuff that results in a ton of strikeouts in a tough spot like this. That is a big-time benefit. Runners on first and third, two away. Next pitch is outside.
Now, as a hitter, when a guy like this comes into the game, you feel like he's standing on top of you, and it's just attack mode coming right at you, expecting to get a swing and miss.
The 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. Popped up. And that'll do it.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
Five runs, eight hits, no errors. They left five men on base.